I want to talk to you about the most common mistakes I see people doing with connecting AES50 devices to the Behringer X32 or Midas M32. Let me show you some of these mistakes that I constantly see people doing. Now, on the back of your X32, you have two AES50 ports. You have an A port and a B port. And this can connect to really any AES50 device as long as it is running at the same sample rate as your Behringer X32. So that can be either 48 kilohertz or 44.1 kilohertz. If you're trying to connect a 96 kilohertz device to this on your AES50, it will not work. You will need to push that into 48K mode. The second thing I see a lot of people doing is plugging in two AES50 cables into the same stage box. And as we can see, I have two cables connected into this SD8. And we can also see that we have two green lights showing us that everything is okay. But if we go back to our actual X32, we will see that we also have green lights. However, this is not functioning correctly. Even though it shows green on both of these ports, it doesn't actually work this way. So I currently have the A port of the X32 connected into the B port of the SD8, and then the A port of the SD8 is connected back into the B port of the X32. Now this would be typical if you were running with a redundancy. However, these stage boxes and the X32 and M32 do not run in a redundant mode like this. So this will not work and will actually give you some issues when you are running it. So don't do this. So the correct way of connecting your AES50 devices is coming from the port of the console into the A port of your stage device. And then if you need to daisy chain to another stage device, you would come out of the B port of that first unit, going into the A port of the second unit. And the very last thing is making sure you are using shielded Cat5e cable. So it does need to be a shielded connector, and it is much recommended that you are using an Ethercon shell that is also grounded to the same ground bond as this shell here on the actual RJ45. By doing this, this will make it so that you do not have any pops and drops and clicks, as well as giving the most robust quality out of your X32 audio. Hopefully this helps.